staff and 6 faculty positions with an average annual salary between $90,000 and $150,000. The facility is expected to house 40 research professionals. The Florida Cabinet voted unanimously to approve the transfer of 3 parcels of land totaling 2.02 acres to the University of South Florida, with a deadline to transfer ownership to the hospital by June 30th of this year. And those are the headlines from The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM and 1370 AM.
Ocala's Information Station, 1370 WOCA. Ocala!
It could be late in the midnight hour. If my soul is in distress, you remind me that with you I'm blessed. Let go of the stress, a present help in trouble.
That's what I believe,
that I can't lose as long as I know that you're there.
Wow. Just when I need. That is Latisse Crawford. I have my videos, my monitor here on my computer filled with her beautiful face right now, Robin.
Yeah.
And I have my headphones filled with her beautiful voice.
She's
on the phone. So what an honor to be able to say she's on our show. And she's got something very, very cool that if you are a singer and perhaps you'd like to be doing what Latisse Crawford is doing, maybe there's a way with what she's going to tell you about right now. I hope I stumbled through that correctly. You know, I'm always made nervous when I see a pretty woman. I don't know what it is about me, Robin.
I don't know
what God did to me to make me jitter when I'm looking at a pretty... She's not even in the room.
No.
Her face is on the... But she's on the phone.
That's right.
Latisse Crawford is a gospel singer. You probably figured that out. A writer, a fashion designer, a spokesperson for the American Stroke Association's campaign called Power to End Stroke. She's on the phone to talk about that campaign, but also to talk about her music. And there's another thing also. It's the most powerful voices online singing competition. So we've got a lot to talk about in just a few minutes. So let's not make her wait any longer. Latisse Crawford. Good morning, Latisse.
Good morning.
Oh my goodness, such a soft-spoken lady. How can you have such a powerful singing voice?
I don't know. I think something happens between singing and talking. I don't know.
Oh man, listen to you. Where are you? Where are you calling from?
I'm in New York. I am home.
Home. I can even hear it. I can hear it in your voice. When you sing, you don't have the New York accent. Well, how come when you a different person comes through you when you sing? Is that right?
Yes, I think so.
Is it snowing there right now? I guess I should ask about the weather. Everybody else is.
No, it was snowing the other day. I woke up and my son was yelling, "It's Christmas, it's Christmas."
How old is he?
He just turned 3 in December.
Oh, my goodness.
Nice.
Well, was it snowing on Christmas or no?
Yes, it did snow on Christmas, so I think for him, anytime he sees snow, he's looking for presents.
Oh, no. Oh, no. You better sell lots of records. Or CDs, whatever.
He's his baby, so he's like the week before, his birthday is like the week before Christmas, so I get a double whammy.
Wow.
But, it's good.
We could go all over the map with you. You're such a busy lady. Where's your heart? What's at the top of the passion scale for you? Is it the music? Is it the fashion designing? Is it being a mom?
Music is definitely, a mom would definitely be at the top of my scale.
Yeah.
The music is definitely there too, because it opens up opportunities like this, you know, where I get to, be a judge for such a great campaign, such a powerful cause. So I'm so excited about that. I think the responsibility of the singing is what gets me the most.
Oh, okay. And you... I know you're very young because I'm looking at your beautiful face, but at what age did you start singing?
I have been singing my whole life. I think probably once I started talking, I was singing. I may have been singing before talking. I'm not too sure. But, everyone in my family sings and plays instruments. And,
oh, really?
So, you know, it kind of trickled on down, yeah.
And when it says writer, does that mean songwriter?
Yeah, I'm a songwriter.
Okay.
I got to write... 7 songs on my upcoming project, which will be in stores on January 28th. And I hope I can maybe write a song for the American Heart Association or the American Stroke Association, you know, write a theme song for this cause. That
okay.
might be amazing.
So let's find out about your connection with that. And I hope you say no to this, but maybe no. Have you had a stroke?
I've never had one, but I've experienced it with my grandmother.
Okay.
She had seven.
Seven.
You know, yeah. She was a tough cookie. You know, but the last stroke that she had, you know, ultimately did put her in a wheelchair, and eventually she did pass from it. She was paralyzed, her complete right side.
Oh my goodness.
You know, speech was slurred. You know, but you know, so it made me definitely want to become more aware about it. You know, a lot of those things that cause stroke are hereditary. So, you know, I wanted to be more aware about it, and I definitely wanted to help other people be aware and find preventive methods, you know, for it as well.
Okay. And now because of the fact that you have achieved a level of celebrity-dom, I guess that's a word. I don't know if I made it up or not. But through the music, you're able to be a voice.
Good word.
It's a good word, yeah. But, I mean, you've achieved a level of a place where we know you. We know who you are anyway. And so then when you say something important about something important, we pay attention for some reason. That's just the way society is.
Yeah, I mean, that's what I definitely think that people who are in that kind of light, they have to take some responsibility. You know, we have to find ways to give back because people are listening to us and they're mimicking what we're doing. You know, I just was saying today that I need to start exercising more. I know I'm very slim and small, but people don't realize that, you know, just because you're small on the outside, it doesn't tell what could be on your inside, you know. And because I have a lot of factors against me where I have, you know, about 90% of my family that has diabetes, 70% of them who have high blood pressure and hypertension, you know, I have a lot of those things, yeah, in my genes. So, you know, we have to be those examples for people to, you know, be aware and to really listen and pay attention.
So this is why the American Stroke Association is targeting the African American community specifically?
Oh, yeah. I mean, because, you know, we have such a higher risk. You know, stroke is the number four cause of death and you know, in the U.S., you know, but African Americans are especially at high risk for stroke due to high prevalence of diabetes, high blood pressure, and previous heart disease and stroke, you know. So you see what I mean about, you know, that I'm at a higher risk than some because I have all of these things in my bloodline, you know.
Wow. Would you be singing if a fashion designer found you first?
You know, I probably wouldn't be doing either. I was in the education system for about 12 to 13 years. I wanted to work with kids, you know. So,
you're a teacher?
I was working. Yeah, I was after school teacher. I was a daycare teacher, you know. So that's what I was doing. That was my passion. Singing kind of fell in my lap, but I guess God always knows better. You know, who would have known I would have been here? You know,
being
a judge for this wonderful competition. So,
and I want to make
glad. You know,
I want to make sure we talk about the competition. But just one more thing about you. If we listen to your music, we're not only impressed by your singing, but also by what you're singing about. I mean, you have embraced your faith, and you have no problem sharing it with the rest of us.
I definitely don't. I think that there are so many people who may not ever step into a church building that have a relationship with God. You know, I'm not one of those Christians that think only if you come to church or only if you're in my denomination that you, you know, are representing the kingdom. I think that, like I said, there are so many people that are more about relationship and not religion that, you know, reverence God and they have a great relationship with him. So I'm definitely, you know, more on that side of relationship versus denomination, you know, type of thing. So, yeah.
Did you have to stand strong against anybody who tried to persuade you to maybe go more pop or do anything that compromised what you really truly believed in your heart?
Fortunately enough for me, I never pursued singing. So
singing?
I have never pursued singing. It kind of pursued me and followed me. So when I went into it, I went into it with a, you know, either I get to do what I want to do and how I want to do it, or I walk away from it. You know, it wasn't something that was
good for you.
More important to me. Yeah. In my responsibility, yeah.
Good
so,
for you.
Yeah, you know, it's kind of one of those things. Yeah.
So help me out with this, and then we want to go to the competition. What sells today?
Sure.
Is it CDs or MP3s? And vinyl's out, right? There's no more vinyl? I know that. I saw some in the record store on Christmas time.
I was cleaning up yesterday and found some vinyls and was like, what am I going to do with this?
Right.
I think iTunes probably sells more, and the internet, you know, Amazon and all those kind of things, the MP3s, they definitely sell more.
Oh, wow. Okay. So I'll go to iTunes later on and I'll download some of your music.
Sure.
Yes.
Yeah.
So let's talk about for the I was going to say for the young singers, so tell me if I'm right. Is this for a young competition, or does it not matter? Could an old guy call in and sing? How do you do this?
Yeah,
how do you do
this? This is for any independent gospel artist that's over the age of 18. So whether you are 60, 100, you know, if you're still out there singing, come on and join. It's for singers, choirs, group, holy hip-hop artists. You know, everybody can go to mostpowerfulvoices.org, and they'll receive monthly information about stroke awareness and prevention. I mean, this is a competition that, you know, it's online. You don't have to even leave the comfort of your house or your office. You can sneak under the table and, you know, upload your MP3. But it's the most important thing is that it brings awareness to stroke, you know, and prevention and awareness. It's through the American Heart Associations and the American Stroke Associations, as well as UPTV's Power to End Stroke Cause campaign that educates people about stroke. So, you know, and you can win some cool prizes too. That's always a plus.
Did you learn about the warning signs of stroke because of your grandmother, or did you know what they were before it happened to her?
I actually learned about it very recently. We were talking with Dr. Ronnie, and you know, he let us know that some of the that you can go by an acronym called FAST, F-A-S-T, face weakness, arm weakness, speech difficulties, and then time to call 911.
Oh, wow. Let's see. I'm looking at the page now. It's mostpowerfulvoices.org, and the prizes include cash, performance opportunities, the Roland VE20 vocal performer. That looks cool. The Roland VE5.
You also get a mentoring coach. Yeah, you get a personal mentoring coach with one of my RC Inspiration, my label mate. So that's also awesome. And you get to be judged by me. Woohoo!
Label mate.
Wow.
I want to be somebody's label mate.
Oh, there you go. Just enter the competition.
You got to enter the competition. I don't think I'd win. You have to win. You have to win. Oh, okay. Does the winner get everything on this list, or is this like one prize per winner?
You know what? I'm not too sure about that. I can definitely find out.
You don't even know what the prizes are. Let's see. What do you?
I mean, even if you only get one of these prizes, they are amazing prizes.
Yeah,
you know, they're amazing. You know, yeah, they're amazing. So I definitely would encourage them to go on and register. And the voters, if they register, not only do they receive the monthly information, but they also get entered into a fan prize contest.
Oh, wait a minute. So I can vote on the entries?
Yeah,
okay.
See? Yeah, if you don't sing, go on up there and vote and win the prize.
So what do you play? What instrument?
I don't play an instrument. My voice is my
instrument. Oh, of course, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I was just wondering.
I don't play an instrument. I tried to learn, but I didn't have enough discipline to learn, I kind of put that to the side.
Dion Hipping, he's your label mate, am I right?
Yeah, he's my label mate. He's an incredible writer, incredible artist. If you get a personal coaching session with him, I think, you know, anybody will be amazed. He's an amazing artist.
Latisse, I'm gonna brag a little bit about our community, and I guess Robin and I see the cream of the crop, and that's why it seems like it. But it seems like we have a lot of ultra talented young people in this community who can sing. And they come into the studio. They come in here.
Like,
you know, they
need to tell them to get on this website and go and upload these videos. I mean, you know, we definitely need to get these young people back into the arts. You know, a lot of them are steering away and trying out new things, and you know, they're not always positive. But you know, music is such a positive avenue for them to use. So tell them to get up here. And I mean, like I said, it brings awareness and prevention of stroke. Anybody walking around can be at risk for a stroke. You know, so it's not. Someone who may not be healthy or who may be sick. Sometimes a perfectly healthy person will have one, you know, quicker than someone who's not. So they need to know. They need to know the information for it.
Yeah. Your father was a preacher?
My dad is a preacher, yeah.
Is a preacher. Okay. And where does he... Where is he? In New York?
His church is in the Bronx. Yeah.
In the Bronx?
New York.
Nice. I was baptized, christened, whatever you call it, in the Bronx.
Wow.
On Katona Avenue. There's a little...
So you need to come on by.
Do you know where Katona...
Come on by. We have a good time.
Do you know where Katona Avenue is in the Bronx?
I do. My mom works on Katona Avenue. She's a school teacher.
Okay. Well, you know that church that looks like a castle?
Let me think.
On the north... I guess that'd be on the western end of the road. Northwest, whatever. Anyway, it looks like a castle.
I just lost it. I'll try to find my GPS.
I don't know what it's called anymore, but anyway, it used to be a Methodist church. I don't think it's that anymore.
Are you the only judge in this competition?
No, it's myself and Dr. Ramey. So we get to judge the top 10 finalists. And, you know, that's going to be such a difficult part for me, you know, because there's so many talented people out there.
As I mentioned at the beginning, there's so many things to talk to you about. Just talking to you is fun. So if we go to the website, mostpowerfulvoices.org, the listener can either share this with somebody they know who is a talented singer, or do it themselves if they happen to be one, or sign up to be a judge. I guess you can do that as well. You can get all your friends to sign up and give you a little. Can we stuff the ballot box?
Yeah, I believe, I'm not sure how many times a day you can vote. I can find that information out for you. But you have until March 28th to vote, and the artists have until March 2nd to enter.
And there's somehow a connection with this and learning what to do to prevent stroke.
Yeah, I mean, so everybody's a winner. You know, even if you don't win the actual competition, you get to, you know, save your life. So might as well just sign up.
So when everybody signs up for this, they'll automatically get information about stroke and the warning signs and the prevention?
Yes, you'll get a monthly email.
Oh, that's wonderful.
All of that information. Yeah.
So are you enjoying the winter?
That's what I said. It's amazing.
Just talk to you first.
I'm enjoying the winter. Yeah. I'm not a winter person at all. I am a summer baby. I like the fall. That might be my favorite season. I love the rain. So I think that might be my favorite season of all.
Have you ever been to Florida?
I have. I've been there several times. Several times working and then, you know, sometimes just having fun.
Well, come have fun with us. We broadcast right from the mall.
Yeah.
If you were in here, there's a window that looks out on the sidewalk, and people will be up against the window looking at you.
That's right.
And they and they can hear you because we got a speaker outside. Go ahead, Robin.
Is stroke hereditary?
Some of the warnings. Signs are, well, not the warning signs, some of the causes of it can be something hereditary. Like I said, the diabetes, the, you know, high blood pressure, some of those things are things that are in your genes that you can't really stop yourself from getting. Mm-hmm. Those put you at higher risk for a stroke.
So are you worried about your child? Is there any testing that your child can go through to see if they're susceptible?
I think, you know, you're always worried about your kids, and, you know, I think I'm more worried now about, you know, something happening to me, you know, or my husband, and, you know, him having to be in that position that we were in with my grandmother, taking care of her.
Right.
But, you know, I'm doing everything I can. You know, I made all of my son's baby food from scratch when he was, you know, younger.
Really?
I nursed. I try my best. Even now, I mean, I was just telling them today that my son is such a health nut. You know, he's always like, you know, like I say, he's three, but he's like, Mom, I want salad and seltzer water, and, you know, can I have that? You know, he's such a healthy kid. You know, we keep him very active, and you know, he tries to get down and does his push-ups with my husband, and you know, so it's really good.
Oh, wow.
He's
nice.
Such an example for me. Yeah, he makes me eat a lot better. You know, because I'm looking at him like, well, if he's asking for seltzer water, let me put this soda to the guy.
Is he an only child?
You know,
he is
an only child.
So
he is an only child.
Any brothers or sisters in the future for him?
You know, I think I've been so busy, I haven't even really thought about it yet. He keeps me very much on my toes, so we'll have to see about that one. I have plenty of nieces and nephews and cousins that, you know, we can adopt a kid for a day and give him back.
I know it's probably torture when us radio geeks decide to go into the personal realm with you. So anyway, thank you for being a good sport with that. Latisse, it's an honor to be able to say you are on our show. I love the way you sing. You're a beautiful lady. Is the clothing you're wearing on there, is that something you designed?
No, that's not something I designed, but I am very much into my look. So I sit with my stylist, and, you know, we go over different things that I want. And like I said, they let me be very much in control of what I'm presenting to my audience. So we sit, and, you know, my makeup artist and with the team from the label, and, you know, we come up with these great and wonderful ideas, you know. So I'm just glad everybody's taking so well to it and that they like it.
And Robin can't see the picture, but she has a bracelet on her upper arm.
Oh, okay.
Is that called a bracelet?
Like
what do you call that?
It's just because I'm so skinny, it didn't fit the bottom.
Well, it's a nice look. I don't know why. I like it. Anything would look good on you. That's what I think. I think that's the real truth.
Thank you.
Yeah, I think that's the real truth. Fun interview. Latisse Crawford, thank you again for being on the air with us. Stay warm up in New York, and call us when you have more children. And most
I mean, you'll never get a phone call.
Okay, well then never mind. Just call us anyway. Mostpowerfulvoices.org. Remember, if you're in Ocala, Florida, stop by and make some time with us here in the studio.
I definitely will.
Okay.
Thank you so much for having me.
All right, thank you. We're going to leave actually with the song that we started with. Thank you, Latisse Crawford. What an honor.
Thank you.
All right. We'll be right back.
Just when I need you, I know you'll be there. Just when I need you, not a second late, you're right. Right on time to make a way and save the day. Like a superhero, that's why I never fear you're there.
Just Habitat for Humanity of Marion County is a ministry dedicated to improving lives by providing affordable and decent housing. Help them help others by visiting the Habitat for Humanity Ocala Home Store on Northwest 27th Avenue. To schedule a donation, give them a call and they'll come and pick it up. For more information, visit HabitatOcala.org. Habitat for Humanity of Marion County. Building homes, building hope, building community.
Last year, over $1 billion, that's a B with nine zeros, was left on the table from taxes not done right. But thankfully, H&R Block tax preparers have over 100 hours of training to help you get your piece of the billion back. Come visit us and our friends at H&R Block this tax season at the Paddock Mall, Marion Oaks, and Triple Crown Shopping Centers to make sure you get your maximum refund. Don't forget to check with your favorite nonprofit for referral information where applicable.
Hi, I'm Yvette, and I'm here to tell you a few things about ABC Frederick's Appliance. They sell